Hello, everybody. Welcome again to another exciting episode of Price Links. My name is Phil Flynn. I'm Senior Market Analyst at the Price Futures Group, as well as a Fox Business Network contributor. Once again, I get the man here, the world traveler, all over the place, all over South America, the man that was down into the coffee fields, putting his hands into the dirt, feeling it all. And the question everybody wanted to ask him is, what'd you bring us?
A little bit of coffee. You'll be getting it any time now, as soon as my container load comes in.
Oh, there he is. That's what we wanted to hear. Oh, we love the smell of Jack's coffee when he brings it into the office, you know, and that's what we love when he goes there. But in all seriousness, Jack, you know, there's been a lot of problems with the South American coffee crop. You went down to see it for yourself. What did you discover?
Well, I was in Central America, actually.
And the
crop there is definitely hurt. You could definitely see the effects of the rust. When you talk to the exporters, when you talk to the producers themselves, everybody's talking about a 10 or 15% loss to the crop for the coming year, which is very, very significant.
And you said you saw that. I mean, you went to the trees and you said to fix this problem, they have to cut the branches off.
They basically have to cut the branches off, and if the tree is affected enough, they have to cut the tree back down, almost down to a stump, and let it start to grow again, which it will do, but it takes 2 or 3 years to get that done and before it can start producing again.
But offsetting that, of course, has been the cost of coffee in Brazil, or the massive crop that we've had. And as you know, they mentioned something with the Brazilian government taking steps to try to stop the free fall in price. What do you know about that, Jack?
Well, they've probably put a floor underneath the price with their program here. It's a two-pronged attack on the low prices. Both designed to support the producers down in Brazil, of course, and have a spillover effect supporting prices overall. But it's a two-pronged attack, one that the Brazil government has used frequently in the past is to offer puts to producers, and they're using it this time. Those puts will be valued at $1.43. The Brazil government really has never had to make good on some of these puts, but they might have to this time because the market's showing no signs of going up there. But they will offer the puts at $1.43, but with a date of March, with a calendar date of March for the expiration of these puts. And the producer has the opportunity up until that time to deliver at that price to the government, and the government has to pay it.
Now, they don't grow a lot of sugar there. Did he happen to see the small amount of sugar that they do grow, how that crop's looking there?
The crop in Central America looked a little bit dry. It was really beautiful weather when I was there, blue skies, maybe a few clouds in the sky, but generally very, very dry. And this is the rainy time of year, so they should be seeing at least some rain every day, and they weren't getting it.
The other thing that we want to talk about is cocoa. The cocoa market, of course, there has been some frost in the Ivory Coast. We've seen this big rally in the chocolate. How much damage do you think it is, and how much more legs does this recent rally in cocoa have?
I'm kind of wondering whether it has much more legs at all. It's been a drought situation there. It's been very sporadic rains. They had the initial crop development under dry conditions, and it's been dry over the last few weeks. But it's starting to rain again, and that implies that perhaps we can put a little bit more into those cocoa pods, produce a few more beans, and more importantly, get the harvest started on time. That seems to be what's really driving this thing, is a delayed harvest, and that implies that probably the cocoa is going to be out there. The quality might be hurt a little bit, but there should be some cocoa out there.
Now, we've got some very strong data from Germany as well. Germany's out of a recession. It seems that the demand for chocolate will be stronger than originally thought, because Europe's out of recession, Germany a big producer. It looks like the grind numbers are going to improve. Do you think that's going to continue, or is this just kind of a short-term blip?
Well, I know the cocoa producers are hoping it continues, and I think it can. I think there's been an awful lot of pessimism about world economies when actually when you look at the data, you know, the U.S. economy has been really performing a lot better than you would assume if you just listen to what you hear on the street. And then Europe seems to be coming out of it, as you said, and Europe being a major consumer will continue to produce and buy chocolate. I mean, really, buying chocolate is, after all, it's a luxury item, but it's a fairly cheap luxury item, so I never did think that we were going to see too much loss in demand.
Well, we did see...
Well, you saw some, but you didn't see a huge, you know, not a huge 50% drop-off or anything
like
that.
Well, no, but how do you balance, like right now, we're talking about there's a potential loss of the cocoa crop. The demand expectations are rising. What do you just ignore the demand side at this point and just focus on the crop?
Right now I am, and the reason why I am is because Ivory Coast has sold quite a bit ahead. They were forced by the World Bank to institute a forward selling program, and it's been very successful. For the most part, they were able to capture some very high prices last year before the prices kind of fell out of bed. This year, maybe somewhat lower prices, but they still have plenty to sell, and these prices are pretty high. So I think that they're going to enjoy some higher prices now, and I'm going to concentrate on the supply side for right now. I do think the demand numbers will improve, but we have cocoa available, and it's a question of what you're going to be your supply to use ratio. And if the supplies are there to meet the use, then prices will stay moderately strong. If the supplies do start getting tighter, though, then we can start to see further legs to this rally later on.
Back to coffee. What kind of new coffee did you find to sell on the cash side?
Well, I can sell all qualities, really, but I think I'm hoping that I found a really very high quality coffee for us here in Chicago to enjoy, because I know we all like really, really good coffee. This will be from Salvador, probably a Bourbon bean, and I have to get it really cupped and approved by a couple of my buyers, but if all goes well, it'll be up here pretty soon.
Fantastic. Can we bring a bag on the air next time again and show it? Some real beans?
Absolutely.
All right, we're going to bring Jack's beans out here. Jack and the beans. There's no stock, just beans. Be back here on PriceLink so you don't miss that. Thanks, Jack.
Thank you.
You're the man.